Having accompanied Jesus yesterday on his journey into Jerusalem, riding on a donkey, we now catch sight of what happened afterwards. On this Monday of Holy Week, we dive into Luke's version of Jesus' visit to the temple. It's a rare window on the heart of what drives Jesus. It gives an insight into what he is passionate about: justice and equity for all people, prayer and a proper sense of worship, honouring God in every aspect of our lives. Luke chapter 19, verses 45 to 48 read: "When Jesus entered the temple courts, he began to drive out those who were selling. 'It is written,' he said to them, 'My house will be a house of prayer, but you have made it a den of robbers.' Every day he was teaching at the temple, but the chief priests, the teachers of the law, and the leaders among the people were trying to kill him. Yet they could not find any way to do it, because all the people hung on his words." Amen. As we began to discover yesterday, Holy Week is shot through with emotion. On Palm Sunday, Jesus went from being the object of adoration for a cheering crowd to falling down on his knees, crying over a city which he knew was about to reject him. And here again on Monday, as he visits the temple, we find a heightened sense of emotion. Jesus is really angry with those who would make profit at the expense of the poor. The temple was supposed to be a place where those who wished to meet with God and worship God and give to God the glory he alone is due could come and be free from the other burdens they were subjected to in life. And yet, it had become a marketplace. Somewhere people coined it in and lived off the backs of those who could ill afford their excessive charges. We find Jesus overturning the tables of the money changers. And in another place, we're even told that he made a whip to drive the biggest offenders out of the temple. This is a truly righteous form of anger which we find in Jesus. His motive is that everyone should be treated equally in their desire to meet with the living God. He's also eager to see that God is properly honoured by true and untainted worship. How sad it is that the religious leaders were the ones who more often than not gained from money changing and the sale of animals for temple sacrifice. And since they stood to lose most from a change to this corrupt system, it's no surprise they were not at all impressed by Jesus' actions in overturning the tables. It infuriated them. Perhaps they were also unimpressed that he had the audacity to challenge their authority. Little did they know, he was the one who really had authority. Authority given him by God the Father. So although many, many people were flocking to hear Jesus teach, others were plotting his downfall. And of course, as the week unfolds, things get darker and darker. It's a hugely emotional time for everyone. I wonder, where would we place ourselves in this story? Perhaps you feel helpless, at the mercy of the system, put down by those who have wealth, prestige, and power. Speak up. Take a stand for what is right. Put your trust in God, believing that he judges equitably. Maybe like Jesus, you get angry when you see injustice. An up-to-date example would be just last week when the so-called gig economy came into sharp focus on the news. Companies like Deliveroo are making huge profits at the expense of many who are self-employed. These folks make deliveries on cycles and motorbikes, in small vans or cars, whilst often earning less than the minimum wage per hour. I would venture to suggest that this is wholly unacceptable. As a result, sometimes I can hardly bear to watch the news due to man's inhumanity to man. I have to be honest and tell you, it moves me to tears. But it also encourages me to pray for those being exploited, to pray to the one who overturned tables in the temple so that he might right wrongs once again. So let's spend a moment praying together right now. Lord Jesus Christ, would that we were just as passionate as you are when it comes to injustice in our world. There are still so many people who suffer at the hands of those who abuse power to their own ends. Just as you called out those who were unfair in their dealings with others, may we each have the courage of our convictions to do the same. But help us to do this in a manner that brings glory to God. And forgive us also for the times when we ourselves are prone to treat people unfairly, not seeing in them the potential you recognise as human beings who are made in the image of God. As we walk with you through this Holy Week, as we imagine ourselves in the midst of those tumultuous events, Lord, help us. Help us to be spurred on towards change. Change within ourselves, our hearts, our minds, our wills. Change in the way we relate to other people, treating them with dignity and respect. Change in our society so that everyone is valued. Change across our world. Change which brings about your kingdom of justice and peace. For this we pray in your most holy and powerful name. Amen.